Now we will learn how contractors would manage the QuickBooks Online items list of products and services. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. What is the items list? Well, QuickBooks Online does not actually call it the items list. It actually calls it the list of products and services that you offer to your clients. The purpose of this list is to be able to list these items on an estimate or an invoice to clarify each service or product that your client is being charged for. You can track the income by the category of the item by connecting it to an income type of account in the chart of accounts. For example, we have a service called steam cleaning that we list with the other services when we make an estimate or an invoice and send out that document to the client. We want the income that we earn from steam cleaning to be recorded in the income account called Income from Heating Repair. So, when we create this item on the items list, we will connect it to the income account called Income from Heating Repair. And these are the items that we will put on our estimates and our invoices. Notice on the left you have the item name exactly as it will appear when you list it on an invoice or an estimate for the client. And exactly to the right on the same row is the income account in the chart of accounts that we put in the chart of accounts in the previous video that will track and categorize all of the items that we put on an invoice or estimate. Now you may notice that these three items, dewinterizing, replacement pipes, and winterizing, will have their income tracked and categorized into the income account called Income from Plumbing Services. And that means every time we list them on an invoice and record the invoice, the money amounts for these items will get recorded into those income accounts. Now let's add to our list of products and services these items with the names on the left connected to the income accounts on the right. Actually, before we start putting in the items on the items list, we have to make a quick correction in the chart of accounts from the previous video. We're going to quickly reopen the income account called Income from Electrical Work, and we're going to rename it Income from Heating Repair. And I do regret the inconvenience, but it's a nice little review. Click Accounting, Chart of Accounts, find the income account Income from Electrical Work, come across the row to the arrow and choose Edit. Change it to Income from Heating Repair. And that will remind us of how we change the names of the income accounts. Now, here are the items that we're going to add to the items list, and now we have the correct names in the income accounts, which will summarize and categorize the income from the items on the left that in the future we will place on invoices to clients. So this is how we actually add these items to the product and service list. We go to the top right, click the cog wheel, and come across to where it says lists in the second column. The second choice down is products and services. Click it, and now we have the products and service list where we can add items to our items list that we can bill the customer for later. Notice QuickBooks Online already gave you two items on the items list that you can explore and experiment with later. But for now, click New and then click Service. And then we have the new service window, and the name of the first one will be Dewinterizing, and it will be connected to Income from Plumbing Services. In order to do that, we go to the bottom right where it says Income Account, click the pull down, scroll up a little, and choose Income from Plumbing Work, which is the same as Plumbing Services. Click Save and New. And now we have the items on the items list, and this will be available to choose when we make our first invoice. What's the next item? Electrical work, which goes under Income from Heating Repair. So we click New, Service, Electrical Work. And in the bottom right, choose Income from Heating Repair, the account that we just renamed. Save and close. Good. What's next? What about Mason Work? Also goes under Income from Heating Repair. So we click New, we click Service, give it the name, and it goes under Income from Heating Repair. Now, instead of Save and Close, you could pull the arrow and click Save and New, and you can see on the left it's being added. What's next? Replacement Parts. That goes under Income from Heating Repair. So we go Replacement Parts, and it goes under Income from Heating Repair. Save and New. What's next? Replace Pipes, and that goes under Income from Plumbing. So we come here, Replace Pipes, and that goes under Income from Plumbing. Click Save and New. See, we're almost finished. Steam Cleaning goes under Income from Heating Repair, like we talked about. Okay, and Winterizing, which goes under Income from Plumbing Service. Winterizing. Now click Save and Close, and this is what your items list would look like in QuickBooks Online, and now you have many choices to choose from when you create an estimate or an invoice for your customer. Now we are finished with the topic and finished with the video. However, I would like to add something from my own personal experience when giving services to contractors. I know from experience it's difficult to sometimes fit what's in a contract with several agreed upon services into the rigid items list the way QuickBooks expects. If you think about the way a contract looks when your client signs it, it does not look like an items list simply listing the services and showing the prices. So sometimes that's hard to bridge that gap and fit that in. For those people who have difficulty with that, I have a very simple suggestion. In your actual company, you could just make one item on the items list for each income account that you have. For example, for anything that would fall under Income from Plumbing Services, you could just make one item called Plumbing Service. And for anything that would fall under Income from Heating Repairs, you could just make one item on the items list called Heating Repairs. Then when it's time to make your estimate, you can just put into the products and service fields the name of the items that represent the entire category. Then you can put in the description field all the details you like that you can bring over from the contract that the client signed, so the client can see how much you're charging for heating repairs, and the description will explain all the things that you will do for that income service item. That's just a little helpful hint for those contractors out there who have a very messy and detailed contract and might have difficulty fitting it into their items list. However, for the course, we will use the items list that we just put in.